Referee Atsushi Onari gets us underway. Pampaya in the glittering gold in southpaw start. He opens up the front kick and then a high left roundhouse kick. Watch for the excellence of execution in everything that Pampaya does. Step through knee, left cross from the tie. Botello's got to find a way to get on the inside. Get within range, get through the reach and go to the jaw, go to the liver, go to the ribs of Pampaya. He's got to guard up against that left roundhouse kick.
He's got to keep that guard high, but he's also got to start circling. He's got to start circling to his left to avoid that big left roundhouse kick.
Pampaya is patient. Cracks away to the inside lead by the Portuguese. Botello tests the waters downstairs. Needs the right hand for company. Double forearms guard against that left roundhouse kick. Botello far too flat-footed at the moment. He's got to move. He's got to start drifting to his left.
Standing right in front of Pampaya. He's got to start moving, put those hands in, closing that distance. He's right in the perfect zone. That left kick.
That no man's land. In range for everything. Pampaya wants to throw it in. He throws a left hand down the center corridor. Pampaya patience. Very light on the lead leg. Tracks away with that back leg again. That fabled, that feared left roundhouse kick with Pampaya Jitmuangnon. Front kick for the midsection. Sinks into the belly button. There's one to the top of the leg. Roundhouse kick again from Pampaya. Nice right hand lever from Botello. That's more like it from the Portuguese athlete. Roundhouse kick slapped into the lower ribs there off the left from Pampaya. First time in these 4 ounce gloves.
The 4 ounce gloves change a lot of things. They change the defense. They change how you're going to counter, how you're going to move in. You got to be very careful, but it also makes the clinch very effective, and it also adds a whole new element of power to the game.
Botello's dead. He studied tape, a lot of tape with Pampaya, and he said that in what he'd studied and having seen Pampaya get knocked out before, that Pampaya does a little lift often before he kicks. And if he can time Pampaya on that lift, Botello may be able to connect, maybe with a roundhouse kick of his own. But being quite the shorter here, it will take a phenomenal effort to loop the roundhouse kick around the back of Pampaya's neck.
Now that you mention it, you can start to see it. It's like a slight skip with his lead foot when he sets up that big roundhouse kick. It's a slight little step to initiate a little bit more power into the left kick. But it comes very fast. Your reaction time needs to be incredibly quick. Here's Pampaya coming straight through the middle with a beautiful left hand. And there's that left kick again. But Rui Botello was able to catch it on the arm there. He's taking a lot of shots. That's about 6 shots he's been able to catch on the arm. He's got to make sure he keeps that arm looped nice and tight to his head. Ladies and gentlemen, you guys can vote for Bout of the Night on the One Super app. And you can win a trip to join us at a One event, which is probably the greatest event in the world of sports, Michael Schmello.
In his destiny of champions here tonight in Kuala Lumpur, it's not probably, it is Mitch Chilson.
There you go.
Final One Championship show of the year. Second round of this One Super Series match. Pampaya on debut, taking on Rui Botello. Thailand versus Portugal. Let's see if Rui can pick up that little lift that Pampaya does before he kicks. He believes it could be the chip in the armor. Something I've never seen before. Pampaya's trainer has his marker around his neck. Now, it's usually on a ring post. There are no ring posts here with the cage, however, but I hope in a very superstitious martial art that does not bring Pampaya any bad luck. Probing the leg kicks here. Rui Botello, forearms guard against the high left roundhouse. Goes for the inside thigh. Nice and high to that femoral profundo with Pampaya. Botello in the traditional Portuguese colours, the green and red.
Go!
Rotella looks very effective when he's moving forward. When he starts throwing those hands, he closes the distance quick, but he's also getting caught with a little bit of a left hook by Pompeyac.
Rotella landed a good combination a few moments ago that should give him some more confidence. Goes for it again. A cracking roundhouse kick from Pompeyac came agonizingly close. Patello fires out a front kick off the back leg. Pompeyac left drop down the center. Body kick from the Thai. Roundhouse kick upstairs again. Patello sees them coming. It's one of those wicked roundhouse kicks like down or like Yodson fly. It could do so much damage. Fake there from Pompeyac. Goes upstairs again, just breaking down that right arm of Rui Patello. There's only so many kicks Patello can take to that right forearm before the arm drops. And then we'll see if Pompeyac can come over the top with a big kibosh.
I'd like to see Pompeyac start going to the body of Botello more. Get him to start protecting that rib, that right side of his body with the elbow, and then he can start working his way up to the head. Botello's okay to take those on the arm.
Botello unloading on Pompeyac for a moment with a crowd rally behind the Portuguese star. Under a minute remaining, second round of three. Three judges are scoring on a 10-point must system. You give the winning boxer 10 points, a less dominant boxer 9 points. Oh, there's the big roundhouse kick! Patello's on rubber legs, he goes down!
5, 6, 7, 8.
Patello's up with a count of 7. Pompeyac gonna finish the Portuguese warrior. This place goes bananas.
Patello's gotta start moving. He doesn't want to stand there. He doesn't want to stand in front of Pompeyac.
Here comes Pompeyac. Is he gonna finish? A left hand smack back between the eyes.
Patient Pompeyac is weighing, measuring. You might let Patello off the hook here and let him out of this round.
Patello still hasn't the cobwebs, and that's a 10-8 round for Pompeyac.
Watch this beautiful left high kick. He faints with the push kick. He was landing the push kick all night. Lifts that push kick up and then comes right over the top. Look at the delayed reaction. Botello crumbles to the ground. Let's see that from a different angle. Beautifully done. Botello thought he was going to the body, kept the elbow tight, and he got caught right on the right side of his head. Beautifully timed right high kick.
Don't forget to check out our official One merchandise. Go online, shop.onefc.com. I told you that Pompeyac was the excellence of execution in Muay Thai, and you saw one of the finest roundhouse kick knockdowns you're ever gonna see from that man, Pompeyac. Third and final, unofficially, first round Pompeyac 10-9, second round Pompeyac 10-8. That is our unofficial scorecard.
Final round!
Go!
Atsushi Onawe gets us up the way, third round. The crowd want to see a big knockout. Pompeyac came close to it with that roundhouse kick in the second stanza. What a weapon, what ferocity!
Tell him he needs to glue that right hand to the side of his head. He says he was going to circle left, but he's still standing right in the pocket. Intent to trade with Pompeyac. It's a recipe for disaster, though.
Botello has not adhered to the game plan he said he would. Big front kick there from Pompeyac. There's the high kick again. He's got more kick than a drowning horse, has Pompeyac. Botello puts it on the inside. Catches the kick again. Tries for a left hook.
That's his combination. He goes through that push kick with the lead leg, with the lead right leg, and then he comes over top with that right left roundhouse kick. He faked it, and that's what caught Botello. He was expecting the push kick to come in, but he faked it, lifting up his left right foot and coming over the top of the left kick.
Go!
Pompeyac looks fresh. Not a drop of sweat on him. Not a bruise, not a scratch. He has been dominant in his one Super Series debut. And that left roundhouse kick has been something extraordinary to behold. Inside leg kick from Patello. Probing with the jab, the Portuguese. Lots of go to his left. He continues to wear these roundhouse kicks. That one was dropped to the ribcage. 1 minute 20 remains. Umpayak sends him 5 paces back with a front kick to the solar plexus.
Those push kicks that are setting up that left roundhouse kick, it comes from the front with the lead leg, and it's also coming from the back. It's both an offensive and defensive weapon.
Oh, he knocks him! The left hand! Referee O'Neary says no knockdown, but that was a beautiful left hand from Botello.
So give Botello some confidence. He needs to take advantage of that.
No knockdown, says the referee. Can Botello capitalize, though? That left hand's been his best weapon, the little man from Portugal.
Hear the cracking sound that left kick is landing on the right hand of Botello.
Stop. And the clinch here, no knees exchange. Referee O'Neary breaks it. Does Botello get another one of those left hooks in the final 25 seconds? Left hook, right hand, the old 3-2 combination there from the Portuguese. Botello's got a swing, and he's got a swing now. Final 10 seconds. It'll be a decision win for Pampayak unless Botello can find a Hail Mary left hook here.
So
push kick from Pampayak.
Look at the way he's throwing those push kicks, Michael Cimello. He's consistently attacking with the front push kick, with the back push kick. And that's what led to the damage that was inflicted in the second round. He was landing that push kick, and then he fakes the left push kick. Watch his right, watch his left leg. Boom, it comes up, gets Botello thinking about it, and boom, he comes right over the top, and Botello crumbles to the ground. Beautiful display of Muay Thai craftsmanship from Pampayak. But Botello started to come back and surge ahead, surge forward, rather, in that third round. But overall, Pampayak, brilliant performance in his debut in one Super Series.
Pampayak looking unscathed. We believe the winner's medal will go back to Thailand. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Pampayak Jitmuangnon.
No doubt about it, Pampayak takes it by decision here in Kuala Lumpur. The winner's medal goes back to Thailand. What a debut at one Super Series.
From Cambodia in the right. Traditional respect before they engage. And the Iron Man unleashes with kicks to the inside of the leg, to the outside, and then a teep kick takes one in return. It's a battle of the feet at the moment. Exchanging, slapping kicks that will leave bruises for sure. And it's Sok T who's on the rough end of it. He goes upstairs, Rodtang.
Some slow motion replays on those kicks of Rodtang. Those are coming with some serious speed.
Real hit. 30 seconds. The hands come into play as well at the 42nd mark. Sok T just hoists up his shorts, seeking any protection he can get from these body blows that are coming in at pace. Lightning quick, Mitch.
It is, and it's coming with some serious power as well. You hear it's a slap, but there's also a thud to the inside of that leg kick as well. Sok T can't allow Rodtang to back his back up against the fence right there. You can see him just slowly inching forward, throwing those leg kicks to just kind of pin Sok T there. Alexi, Sok T circle out.
It's not an exaggeration to say that these kicks are coming in so quickly. Sometimes you're not sure what you've seen. Nice left hand work. Goes body and head, Rodtang. Superb offensive work here, and he bashes himself in the chest and in the face. He's taken more punishment from himself than he has from his opponent in the last 10 seconds. Really up for this. And those legs of Sok T are taking some punishment. He just pushes his opponent back 4 or 5 feet. giving himself a little bit of respite. Doubles up on a jab that lands short. But at the moment, he's off the pace.
Santi's kind of mesmerized at this point. He's got to do something to earn the respect of Rodtang.
These two hyper-experienced 21-year-olds.
Wow, he fainted the jab and then came around to the beautiful left hook.
Santi just showing us the potential threat there with a big overhand right that might possibly have brushed the nose of Rodtang. But at the moment, all of the really quite exquisite work is coming from the tie. And it's relentless. There's no room to breathe. They keep coming in every couple of seconds. Jab, kick.
And his leg kicks are starting to add up.
Sotti gives him a nod after receiving a left hook to the jaw. A nod of respect. Left, right, followed up by kicks. This is exhibition stuff from the Thai athlete.
Leg kicks.
Left hand, and down goes Sotti, and I'm not convinced that he's getting up. He clearly hurt his leg. He's nodding, yes, I can continue, but it doesn't look feasible, Mitch, does it? Saved by the bell.
Wow, those leg kicks are some serious trouble. He was hammering the inside and the outside, and Sokti just fell down.
Look how much trouble he's in, Mitch, struggling to even get on the stool. He's got 1 minute to make amends.
Rodtang just getting aggressive here, punching himself in the face. Like you said, he hit himself more times than Sokti's hit him.
He is like a man possessed. And how about a stamp dance? You think she's enjoying herself?
Yeah, the stamp dance here in Bangkok is definitely a sight to behold. But man, those leg kicks. Just punishing. I don't know if Sokti's going to be able to walk back out to the center of the circle.
Well, I'm personally very glad that he got to the bell because I want to see more of this. This is an exhibition. But how much longer can it last? That left leg of Sokti is red.
Let's see Sokti's change in the southpaw stance here.
Go!
Look at the focus on that time. He is like a man possessed.
Sokti's got to check some of these kicks.
Oh, left hand, right kick, deep kick. Sokti comes back with something, and that's what he has to do. He's got to send a message to his opponent. Meanwhile, right, left, that leg is in big trouble, isn't it?
He's just walking him down, putting his back up against the fence, and then just throwing some nasty combinations. They're all ending with leg kicks.
You've got to admire Sokti's resilience here and the resistance, but for how much longer? Superb left hook to the body, like Barry McGuigan of old in the 80s. Once again, left hand and right hand. Kicks to the body as well. Again, he goes downstairs with that wonderful left hook to the body.
Aggressive Rodtang marching forward. The tank is rolling through Bangkok.
That is a gorgeous left hook to the body. That leg, how much more can it stand? Again, he goes left hook to the body, right to the head, kicks to the left leg. Sokti stays on his feet. Directly above us here, circle side, in Bangkok at the Impact Arena. Rodtang is thrilling these fans.
How tough is Sokti? He's still in it. He's not backing down. He's not going anywhere.
Left hook to the body. The tree has come down. He attacked that trunk. Runs across the circle. Sits atop. Taps his chest and says, hey, who's number one? It could well be me. What a performance, as close to exhibition Muay Thai as we've seen for quite a while. Of course the respect that we're used to seeing. Sokti, for the time being, unable to get to his feet. But that did not stop Rodtang from going over there and offering his condolences. That left leg of Sokti was taking huge punishment. You can see him hobbling around, doing all he can, but that was the finishing blow. inside and outside of Sopti's left leg, and then a barrage of punches. Left, right, left, right, left, right. Sopti's left leg is going to be sore tomorrow. It's pretty sore now. That was the finishing combination. Dom Lau will sum this one up for us, but we all know who's won.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 36 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of knockout, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Marvelous, marvelous effort that was from Rodtang, the Iron Man. Jitmuangnon.
Ready, ready, go!
Good luck charms used in Muay Thai, a very superstitious martial art that dates back thousands of years. And this one, though, under kickboxing rules, the elbows and the extensive pressure knees will not be permitted here. A groin strike early on, accidental to Masahide Kudo.
Ladies and gentlemen, our referee has pulled 4 games of the time. Our athlete has up to 3 minutes.
There will be injury time up to 3 minutes of the extension of a round allowed here for Kuda. During a groin strike, what happens is the pain travels from the groin up the peroneal and pudendal nerves and the spermatic plexus, which feels like death has come from the lower part of the body. Very, very painful indeed as we have a look at the replay of what happened here. The accidental kick went for the inside thigh, a little too high though, from Pompeyak, and Masahide Kudo is the recipient. Groin signals get worn in the brain at a speed of around 265 miles per hour. It's your body basically giving the brain notice that something is very, very wrong and very, very sore. Akudo is okay to continue here. Straight back on the action. Southpaw stance on Pompeyak Jitmuangnon. Jab there from Pompeyak. Nice high lift roundhouse kick from the Thai. Good threaded jab from Pompeyak. Body head goes Kudo. You'll need to rely on the speed here, Masahide Kudo. Try and fluster Pompeyak with the combinations. Pompeyak will rely more on their single strikes, loaded with power. They clinch up in tango, and referee Onari breaks them. Front bridge and left hand there. 4 ounce gloves in use for this one. No margin for error when you're using 4 ounce gloves. Good popping right hand there, being the jab off the southpaw of Pompeyak Jitmuangnon.
Kudo's trying to reach out, he's trying to paw that lead hand of Pompeyak. He's having a hard time with the range of Pompeyak. Narrowly missed with that big left kick.
Go!
Just a warning there from referee Onari. Front kick for Pompeyak. Kudo trying to get to the inside. Pompeyak sticks out the jab. Quickly Harlan's roundhouse kick. Going for the headache maker. Inside leg kick there from Pompeyak. It just drains the cup again of Kudo. Perhaps that's a lower that inside leg kick. Often a problem when competing as a southpaw. I'd like to go for the inside lead thigh, and it can often lead to groin strikes. Unintentionally, of course. It is one of the side effects of competing against a southpaw. Stiff left hand there, being the rear hand of Pompeyak. You can see in his mind it was ticking over. Kickboxing rules, you can't throw the elbows.
Beautiful push kick.
Back up after that push kick. It was very nicely placed, Mitch.
The timing was absolutely excellent. Just taking Kudo up off his feet.
Jab working well for Pompeyak so far. Kudo again gets to the inside and gets punished with the left cross. Couple forearm guard against the round kick. Pompeyak looking very relaxed, moving well, jabbing off the back foot when he does drift backwards.
Kudo's having a real hard time with the range of Pompeyak. Every time he enters into Pompeyak's just sort of his zone, he's getting lit up.
Round kick again from Pompeyak for power. Not getting through the forearm though. but breaking down the forearm of Masahiro Kudo. What the Muay Thai athletes love to do, they'll kick away over and over again the forearm, that uterus, until the opponent drops the arm, then they can power over the top with no defense. One down and two to go. Folks, don't forget, follow us on all your social media platforms at One Championship on Twitter, on Facebook, on YouTube, and on Instagram.
Let's take a look at that timing of Pompeyak. Just an absolute thing of beauty. He's able to read Kudo coming forward and then just puts it right into his chest, taking Kudo up off his feet and putting him down on his backside. Just a beautiful timing of Pompeyak is something really special to watch there on that push kick delivery.
Very good start from Pompeyak Jitmuangnon using the jab well. Kudo not having his distancing quite right yet, having trouble getting on the inside to land the clean salvos. Kickboxer versus Muay Thai stylist from inside the sold-out Phu To Indoor Stadium in Ho Chi Minh City, Vietnam. Three judges are ringside. They are scoring on a 10-point must system. Winner of the round gets 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. Nicely placed there from Pompeyak. Just a warning, if you're going to clinch up, you can only do so for a few seconds. You've got to stay easy in the clinch and throw the knees. Otherwise, the referee will break you under these kickboxing rules.
See, Kudo's trying to enter into the range, but he's dropping his head down, which is sort of a dangerous move to do, especially with Pompeyak. He's got excellent timing. Let's see, meet him. Throwing a knee here. You watch him come in right there, drop his head down a little bit. It's lit up there.
That left roundhouse kick is coming agonizingly close to the back of the neck of Masahiro Kudo. Portion to watch the fathers with the head. A beautiful push to bear from Kudo for the second time. Kudo comes forward, throws to the inside leg, forearms up against the round kick again. Chance for the knees. Pompeyak doesn't throw them. Referee Onari breaks. Round kick once more. Smashes into the right forearm of Kudo. There's the stinging left cross. Kudo gets caught with a jab. It was a jab off the back foot from Pompeyak. Having no trouble adjusting to the kickboxing game so far, Pompeyak Jitmuangnon, a multiple Muay Thai world champion. Circling clockwise is Kudo, staying away from the power side of Pompeyak. Looping left hand from Kudo, almost left himself exposed. Maybe some frustration creeping in here, Mitchell Masahiro Kudo. Beautiful left hand there from Pompeyak. You can see the damage on the right eye of Kudo. That left hand of Pompeyak has caused some welts on the cheekbone of Masahiro Kudo. High kick again from Pompeyak. There's another drilling left hand. Pompeyak on fire here in the second, and Kudo has no answer.
You see, Kudo's just kind of, he's really frustrated here. Every time he comes forward, gets into the range of Pompeyak, he gets touched up for his trouble. You can see how big Pompeyak is able to compete off his back foot. Watch how he strikes off his back foot. It's just an absolute thing of beauty. Looking at that right jab, consistently touching Kudo.
Front kick from Pompeyak, Kudo ties him up. Chance for the knees, doesn't throw any. 20 seconds remains. Good jab again from Pompeyak. More jabs than a pin cushion for the tie in these two rounds. Whipping round kick. You feel at some stage he's going to connect with that shin to the side of the neck. Hit the carotid artery. Body shot from Kudo. Locks him against the ropes. Referee Onari breaks them. He will go into the third and final round on this one. And Pompeyak seems to be in control. Once again, folks, winner of the round gets 10 points. Most dominant boxer gets 9 points. Who you have it for so far after two?
Kudo is doing a decent job, though, of keeping that hand up nice and tight to the side of his head, which is imperative that he makes sure he keeps that hand glued to the side of his face, because Pompeyak is coming agonizingly close to ending his night. You can just see that timing of Pompeyak, the way he's able to move backwards and forwards to create these openings and land just some beautiful shots. His jab is lightning fast. I'd like to see Kudo maybe start to utilize the leg kick, go inside the leg and start working off some angles.
because he's got to change things up. And I think at this point, either A, he's got to get a knockdown, or B, he's got to close the show and knock out Pampayak.
It's the third and final round. Pampayak and Masahiro Kudo. It's one Super Series kickboxing flyweight action inside the sold-out Full Tour Indoor Stadium in Ho Chi Minh City, Vietnam, for the first time ever. How do you score it, folks? Very good second round for Pampayak. And Kudo get on the inside. He needs speed. He needs quarter angle turns. He needs lateral footwork. He tries for a hook. He gets tagged with the jab. And here comes the round kicks again from Pampayak. There's the cross from Pampayak. And the round kick once more. Breaking down the forearm of Kudo. Kudo trying to pin him against the ropes, and Pampayak spins him around wisely. Kudo's got a cut to the side of the left eye. Maybe a jab that he acts off the right hand of Pampayak. There's another jab, and Kudo backs him off with a right cross. Pampayak on the outside. Kudo ties him up, chance for the knees. Referee Onari gives him a slap and breaks them. Pampayak resets. Forehand blocks, the power of the hand, the power of those shins. Kudo eats another jab. Roundhouse kick from Pampayak. The Muay Thai roundhouse kick can travel at 135 miles an hour, 209 kilometers an hour. It is a ferocious martial arts weapon. Imagine the impact of a multi-time Lukumia Rechtenberg World Champions roundhouse kicks cracking away your ribs, coming for your neck, cracking away your forearms. It's scary.
You can see, but Kudo's not fazed by it. He continually pushes forward, even though he's running damage on his face. He's actually been able to land that right hand a few times in this round. Job of maintaining his distance and keeping Kudo in exactly the range he wants.
A jab, little turn off the ropes there from Pampayak. Now he's looking like a kickboxer. He's moving, and he's jabbing. Beautiful evasion from Pampayak. But a palm heel strike there. Kudo eats another jab. That lead hand of Pampayak Jitmuangnon has been an absolute threat. Time and time again here, slipped through the defenses of Kudo. And Kudo's had no comeback. He's punching without payment. Kudo skips forward, eats the jab once more, and Pampayak digs away to the ribcage, left side of the carcass. Look at Pampayak, high on the balls of his feet, oozing with confidence. Nice evasion, slips to the outside, double jab, catches him with the chin. There's the round kick while he was moving backwards, very hard to throw. Drifts back to centering now, Pampayak. Skips out of the way of the jab of Kudo. Pampayak off the ropes. Front kick. Body shot there from Kudo. Refriel Nari breaks them. 30 seconds remaining here, Dragon. Third final round.
That jab is a thing of beauty coming from Pampayak. That's going to do all the damage to the side of the face there. And that push kick is something true. It's a special treat, too. And that's what Kudo needs to do. He needs to get close. Let those hands go.
Pampayak having work with Kudo here. They go in the fight booth now. Look at the respect between these two men.
Very good performance from Pampayak Jitmuangnon. Looked absolutely exceptional in each one of these rounds. Just putting out that jab, consistently touching the face of Kudo. Every time he tried to enter into his range, he got touched up with that jab. But then also that push kick was a thing of beauty. Really just putting on a clinic. A Muay Thai clinic, but in a kickboxing match. Just did an absolutely exceptional job. A striking performance put on by Pampayak Jitmuangnon.
Absolutely no problem in transitioning to the kickboxing rules for the first time in his career. Pampayak Jitmuangnon, a masterclass performance. Let's go to Tom Lau for our decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the Red corner, Hanpayak Jitmuangnon.
In this heated flyweight division, Hanpayak Jitmuangnon sends a very clear message. He can do it Muay Thai rules, he can do it kickboxing rules.
Ready, ready,
it's
go!
Tyler Hardcastle in the blue trunks, and Jitmuangnon is in the black shirts. Southpaw stance with Tyler Hardcastle as Jitmuangnon starts to march forward. Watch for Tyler Hardcastle to circle to his right side. He wants to avoid the power side of Jitmuangnon.
Jitmuangnon starting out very aggressive.
You can see Tyler Hardcastle has a very authentic Muay Thai style. Very slow paced, has that little bit of a stalking style. Jitmuangnon says he wants to be more aggressive. He wants to push the pace because last time he felt he was holding back. This moment, this atmosphere got the better of him. But he is excited to have one more shot here in ONE Championship Super Series. Jitmuangnon's just trying to attack that inside leg kick. And that's what you get when you get orthodox versus southpaw athletes, is that inside low kick can just go a little bit low.
Go!
Marching forward, he's trying to bait. This is different for Jitmuangnon. Jitmuangnon's usually the counter striker. He's the one pushing forward. He's trying to cover that distance. Nice head kick into the clinch. Inside the clinch. Look at that high clinch that they both have. Trying to create that little bit of distance.
Nice jab there by Hardcastle.
Big knee landed there by Jitmuangnon inside that clinch. And that's that Thai style. This is what you were talking about when you said Thai style versus Thai style, is they both want that slow pace, punch into the clinch, and utilize those knees and elbows.
Nice little shift to the left. Right batter. Land a leg kick of his own. Hardcastle. Jitmuangnon believed that his... He's superior in the clinch, but Hardcastle's holding his own right now.
Hardcastle has a huge win over Samopech Vertex, who's also a ONE Super Series athlete. And that is a huge victory, and that's what got him noticed to get here into ONE Championship. Big knee flying into the corner there of Jitmuangnon as he's inside that clinch. Azushi Onari separates the two. They gotta be active inside the clinch. You have to keep throwing those knees and elbows. You can't just sit there hugging each other.
Hardcastle has been finding that back leg push kick.
Like how he's circling out. He punches and then he immediately circles. He's not allowing Jitmuangnon to press him back into that corner.
That seems to be a strategy for tonight. Also doing a great job of landing punches off the clinch.
Every time they separate, that's when his openings present himself. I'd like to see him step in maybe off of that clinch and throw those elbows. Just create a little bit tighter angles.
I agree.
You're in the corner of Hardcastle. What are you telling him?
Hardcastle needs to up his volume a little bit. He's letting Jitmuangnon dictate the pace. Tyler Hardcastle needs to engage on, be the first to engage, initiate the strikes. And as soon as they go to the clinch, Tyler Hardcastle is still waiting a little bit. Jitmuangnon is able to get off a couple strikes before Tyler Hardcastle responds.
In the corner of Jitmuangnon, what are you telling him?
Jitmuangnon doing great. Do the same thing. Keep the pressure on Tyler Hardcastle. Land the kicks that he's been landing.
Typically in Muay Thai, we see that first round nice and slow, just trying to understand the distance, the timing, and the range of your opponent. And that's what we saw in that first round. Not a lot of aggressive shots coming forward. Nobody really taking control. A lot of back and forth action. They spent a lot of time inside the clinch.
Round two. Go!
Jitmuangnon immediately starts to come forward. Oh, beautiful left hand landed by Tyler Hardcastle.
Tyler Hardcastle coming up aggressive this round.
Dumped there by Jitmuangnon as he catches the kick and pushes him forward. I like to see Hardcastle throw those hands. He's doing well inside the boxing. Find the jab and then throw that left hand.
That's what he needs to do. He needs to initiate the attacks first. Not wait on Jitmuangnon.
Inside the clinch. Jitmuangnon is so tough inside that clinch. He's so powerful when he starts redirecting you. His balance is just so superior. And that's where the kind of experience that you get with over 300 professional Muay Thai matches. Experience that beautiful timing. All he waits is for that slight off balance, and he can put you on your butt.
Go!
See, the guard's really high for your opponent.
That left straight has been landing through the guard for the Tyler Hardcastle.
That left straight, that's his money shot. He needs to keep throwing that over and over again, but I'd like to see him set it up.
Your opponent now has been more active inside the clinch.
Now, a lot of times, those clinches, those dumps, those redirects, those actually count as clean strikes. So if you land a beautiful dump, it's going to actually score in the judge's eyes as well. So Tyler Hardcastle's got to be very careful inside that clinch. Skips forward into the clinch. That's what he wants. That's where he wants this to be. He wants to be inside that clinch, working those elbows.
That was a great job by Tyler Hardcastle of timing Jitmuangnon coming in, landing a combination of his own.
Jitmuangnon just competed 3 weeks ago in Thailand and did very well. He's looking to carry that momentum into this match, which is kind of what he's doing. But Tyler Hardcastle is keeping it very tight by scoring with those hands.
Jitmuangnon is doing exactly what he said he was going to do. He feels that he has the advantage in the clinch and has been doing that all night. Landing some good knees, good strikes inside of the clinch.
He's not giving Tyler Hardcastle any space. He's consistently pushing forward and shutting down the hands. So Tyler Hardcastle is only able to get one shot off, and he's got to make it count.
Go!
Tyler Hardcastle tried to parry away as the Jitmuangnon came in. He tried to step to the side. It was a nice little parry. But Jitmuangnon saw it coming and shut down the kick. He does so well with the kicks and the counters. As he's catching the kicks, he's answering with something. His timing is beautiful. Take us through some of this action, Gianni.
Look at the action right here. Good left hand landed by Hardcastle. Head kick push. Jitmuangnon catches the kick, trips him, and here's the dump right here. Lands a knee in the clinch, gets double unders, lifts him, elevates him with his knee, and dumps him. Masterful work there by Jitmuangnon.
That is beautiful. Now we're starting to see this world championship experience start to shine. He's putting on a clinic inside the clinch. Tyler Hardcastle's got to start circling out. He's got to throw those hands and stay away from that clinch. This constant dumping is going to slow down Tyler Hardcastle's momentum.
Tyler Hardcastle found success in the second round. Moving backwards, waiting for Jitmuangnon to come in and land combinations of his own. He needs more of that this round. He needs to initiate his strikes and not let Jitmuangnon dictate the pace of this third round.
Jitmuangnon immediately starts to come forward, takes the center of the ring. Hardcastle, he's listening to you. He's throwing those hands immediately, but he just can't stop the clinch of Jitmuangnon. Jitmuangnon wants. He wants to shut down the strikes, close that distance, get right inside that clinch, give Tyler Hardcastle zero space to work any of his strikes.
Jitmuangnon really putting on pressure on Hardcastle this round.
Marching forward, finding that range. It's so difficult to do anything when you have a world champion, the caliber of Jitmuangnon throwing those shots at you.
Go!
And even like when Tyler Hardcastle's throwing punches, you can watch little subtleties how your Pyeongwang is actually hitting the punch as Tyler Hardcastle throws it.
That's the experience of your Pyeongwang. He's seen everything.
He's only 25 years old and he's competed over 300 times in professional Muay Thai.
Tyler Hardcastle has just given up too much ground right now. He's not gaining the respect of Yot Pyeongwang. Yot Pyeongwang is comfortable with walking him down because Hardcastle is not landing the punching combinations that he did early in the second round.
Beautiful step aside, head kick. He cut the angle beautifully as Yot Pyeongwang turns it on with knees to the body. Hardcastle has those moments. He has these abilities to shine, but he's just not able to put those moments together consecutively to stop the momentum of Yot Pyeongwang.
He needs to string 2-3 combinations together against Yot Pyeongwang. One combination is not enough. Yot Pyeongwang is just way too experienced for it. But there's a good left hand landed for Hardcastle.
But it landed just off the side of the head, so it's that head movement. Oh, as the knee goes to the body of Hardcastle. Drops him, gets the standing eight count. That might be it. I don't know if Hardcastle can answer the referee. That's a KO.
Lunging to the body, drops Tyler Hardcastle.
Just shuts everything down. It is so painful to get hit with a body shot, ladies and gentlemen. Your entire body turns off. You want to continue, but your body just can't move. Now that is how you redeem yourself here in One Super Series. Your Pyeongwang, Jitmuangnon, is back in the winner's circle. That was so beautifully timed. He jumped in, found that minute space. Check this out. Talk us through this.
Yot Pyeongwang pressuring forward, the knee over there lands. Probably has Tyler Hardcastle hurt already. Doesn't rush it, takes his time. Lunges in, left knee to the body. Yot Pyeongwang systematically brought down Tyler Hardcastle. Look at that, kicks to the body. Taking his time. Little jab. Another jab again to set up the lunging knee right here. Bang, right in the body drops Tyler Hardcastle. Great performance by Yot Pyeongwang Jitmuangnon tonight.
He was methodically moving forward until he found the opening and able to end the night of Tyler Hardcastle. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 11 seconds in the third and final round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Yot Pyeongwang Jitmuangnon.
The six-time Muay Thai world champion puts on a tremendous performance, a clinch clinic here in Jakarta, Indonesia, to finish in the third round with a beautiful flying knee.
Ready, go!
This one brought to you by Hobbs & Shaw. Champion from the UK, left of screen, the challenger from Thailand, right of screen. They exchange round kicks early. Look for the elbows, look for the front kicks. There's one from Haggerty. Look for the sheer brute power of Rodtang. Inside leg kick from the top. More than 140 martial arts world champions on the roster at One Championship. You are seeing two of them in the ring at the moment.
You've
got to wonder, can Rodtang maintain his composure? High check there. Jab two from Haggerty. That's the precision. That's the excellence of execution from the general.
Good work so far from Haggerty, especially with these kicks, man. And that's what he's doing. He's laying that feint. Now he landed a few push kicks, and now he's starting to feint the push kicks. And that's how he sets up those elbows. He slides in forward and throws those elbows off of that fake push kick.
The push kick of Haggerty, one of the best in the business. Pulls the toes back, extends the ball, the foot drives it into the midsection of the opponent. Roundhouse kick from Haggerty. There's the push kick, and it's set Rodtang back against the ropes. Again, the succulent technique of the 22-year-old world champion from the UK. front kick again from Haggerty. Scoring points. We do have three judges ringside. Scoring on a 10-point must system. Give the winning boxer 10 points per round. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. At the moment, with the front kicks, it's Haggerty doing the scoring.
Rodtang's having a hard time with the range of Haggerty. That lead push kick is causing a lot of problems for Rodtang. Rodtang's not used to just standing there taking these shots. He's usually the one pushing forward, throwing those shots.
He is landing every one of these front kicks. There's a downward elbow, hoping to crack the collarbone. When we spoke to Haggerty yesterday, we said, what were you most looking forward to about competing against Rodtang? He said, I can't wait to kick him. I can't wait to front kick him. And he's done plenty of that so far, with 45 seconds remaining in the first round set for five.
It's all those, I like that little change, that little stance change that he does as he throws that right kick.
Haggerty's flyweight Muay Thai world title on the line. There's a front kick off the lead leg from the general. Nice 3-2 combination. Inside leg from Rodtang, the Iron Man. Both wearing the Project armbands, a little more flamboyant. Those around the left bicep of Haggerty. The more super Project around both the biceps of Rodtang. All part of the tradition, the custom, the superstition of Muay Thai, a martial art dating back some 3,000 years. Front kick again, catches up at his Rodtang. Into the round, we go to the towers. Now once again, give the winning boxer of the round 10 points. The less dominant boxer of the round 5 points. We are scoring on a 10-point must system.
Look at that beautiful left high push kick, fakes it, and puts the rope save Rodtang from ending up on his butt there. Just that timing is just beautiful coming from Haggerty. He took advantage of the slow start from Rodtang, and that was an exceptional round for Haggerty.
Now, we will say that traditionally the Thais do start very slow. The reason being, however, in Thailand is that betting is done ringside on the contest, not permitted, of course, here in one Super Series. There's no live betting here ringside, but that's why they start slowly in Thailand. So a lot of Thai combatants you do see start very slow in the first, second rounds of a five-rounder like this is, and really pick up the pace in the third round onwards. So a very slow first round from Rodtang, but over five rounds, as we're scheduled here, maybe to be expected.
With over 300 matches, you think it's hard for him to break that habit of traditionally having a slow start?
And usually in one Super Series, he's used so far to having three rounds, where there's not much time for a filling out process, not much time to wait and see what your opponent's got to offer. You've got to go hell for leather from the opening bell, but here we have five rounds. Front kicks again from Haggerty. Checks the inside leg kick. Rodtang, you feel, is just trying to get his timing off that front kick to work a counter. Maybe it'll be a big overhand right. Maybe it'll be a hooking punch. But that's what he's going to try and time off, the front kick of Haggerty. There you see it again. A catch and counter, scooping to the liver section.
Now he catches it. Now you're starting to see Rodtang. You can see him at the end of that first round kind of pounding his chest, firing himself up, shaking his head. That's the Rodtang we're used to seeing.
There is a moment in previous contests we've seen where Rodtang goes from Bruce Banner to the Incredible Hulk. Are we going to see it here in the second round? We will see it later on. Nice, hook to the outside leg kick there from Rodtang. Haggerty switches stance, southpaw now. Front kick off the back leg, now back to orthodox. Very tight in his guard here, Jonathan Haggerty, the 22-year-old world champion from England. Sticks the front kick into the guts again of Rodtang. Good outside leg kick, harm the thigh there from Haggerty.
Rodtang's starting to evade a lot of these kicks now. He's moving his head a lot better, getting out of the way of these. I think he's starting to figure out the reach there. You can see just how long the leg reach, the advantage that Haggerty has. And Rodtang's starting to figure it out a little bit more. Expect Haggerty to start going to the legs and body a little bit more.
Rodtang has the edge in power, but Haggerty, it looks like, has the edge in speed and precision. Down to the elbow, looks for a dump from Haggerty. A little late in the blow there after referee Onari went to break them, and Haggerty complaining to Onari there.
Yeah, but it wasn't quite really a break. Like, the referee was there, but he didn't really have his hands in there separating them. So I don't know, maybe it was the angle that I didn't quite see, but it looked like Onari wasn't really trying to break him.
Front kick there from Haggerty. Once again, folks, make sure you follow One Championship across all social media platforms, on Instagram, on Facebook, and on Twitter. A lot of fans big hello to Mauro Pomali watching in Tuscany, Italy tonight. High kick from Haggerty. Tried to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Outside thigh kick from Rodtang. Now we're seeing Rodtang raise the mercury, raise the temperature, raise the aggressor meter.
This is what Rodtang has to do.
I'll take my feet.
This is what Rodtang has to do. He cannot allow Haggerty to push forward and be this aggressive. He's got to slow Haggerty's aggression down. Cut him off. Start putting heat on him.
Two down, three remaining. 4 ounce gloves in a 5 round world title match. Once again, folks, whoever was the dominant boxer in the second round, give them 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. A beautiful horizontal elbow there from Rodtang, but was it a little late?
Now, I don't know, man. You can see the referee was just kind of standing there. He didn't have his hands in between. You got to go until the referee tells you to stop, and I think Onari just kind of tapped him on the sides there, and he let him continue. That's when that elbow came.
That was all part of One Championship Tour of Heroes live from the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. This our co-main event for the Flyweight Muay Thai World title. Sellout crowd tonight, the hottest ticket in town. And Haggerty has had a very good opening 2 rounds. But this is where we expect Rodtang to start to uncork the power salvos. Start to light the fuse, to pull the trigger. And we know that he can, unlike any other. If Rodtang decides to put the foot down and turn it on, strap yourselves in for the ride of a lifetime.
Well, Michael, that's what happened to Sam A. Gyeonghadao. We saw Jonathan Haggerty get ahead in the first couple rounds, and Sam A. Gyeonghadao never got a chance to get back into it because Haggerty just kept pouring it on.
And you see Rodtang now. He'll start the showboating. He'll start the theater. Hooking punches from Rodtang. Haggerty tries to dump him. Rodtang looks like he returned the favor. Both men trade knees to the ribs, and referee Onari breaks it.
That's what Rodtang needs to do. He needs to keep Haggerty on his back foot, not allow Haggerty to go forward and control all those feints.
Rodtang coming forward a lot more already here in this third round of five. That's what he does. That's why they call him the tank. He just comes forward and rolls over you. Roger Dunn slipping down. Looks to be leaving there. There's Rodtang. Haggerty tries to counter with a hook off the ropes. Drifts back clockwise. Thrusts out the jab. You see Rodtang trying to walk him down. He wasn't doing that the first 2 rounds. Is Haggerty going to stand with a toe-to-toe? Is he going to play that game? Is he going to try to let Rodtang's ego open him up here? Rodtang goes to the liver. Circles off to his left, but he's going into the power side. Another liver shot, like he's digging for oil. This is a great round for Rodtang. Haggerty evades the leg kick, takes the inside thigh kick, goes high, misses the target. Checks the low kick, jab from Haggerty. Gotta get off the ropes though. Gotta get off the ropes though. Gotta get off the ropes. And now he does after running it over.
It's a much better round for Rodtang. This is what we'd expect from the Iron Man. To go forward and throw
a downward elbow! And a dump out from Rodtang. Another downward elbow! With some big intent from Jonathan Haggerty. But we told you Rodtang would wait to the third round and pick up the punch. Indeed, he's done that in true Thai fashion.
But Haggerty's landing shots too. He's landing a lot clearer shots. We're seeing the aggression from Rodtang, and the crowd might be ooh and on. But Haggerty is picking him away, slowly landing jabs, landing kicks.
Jab 2 combination from the champion on the high kick. Rodtang goes downstairs. Outside leg kick from Rodtang. Left hook. Haggerty fires the elbow. Goes down the center corridor. A beautiful catching dump there from Rodtang. It's scoring stuff from Rodtang. A fantastic round from both men. But do did Rodtang edge that one.
Much better round for the Iron Man, but Haggerty had his moments in that round. He was still utilizing that push kick, but everybody seems to be impressed by what the Iron Man is doing right here. Look at this big right hand. Boom! Touches the ear. Goes digging for earwax like a Q-tip inside the side of that ear right there. Beautiful work done by Rodtang in that third round. That's the Iron Man that everybody in the world of Muay Thai was so excited to see tonight. Now he's starting to bring it out. Very close. How do you have that? Maybe 2-1, maybe 1-2. Oof, interesting. Interesting. Rodtang's getting fired up though as he stood up on the ring ropes. You rarely see people climbing the ring in the middle of the match.
Haggerty's corner, Knowlesy and the crew telling him, go down the center corridor, use your push kick, use your jab, go to the uppercut elbow, come down the center corridor with a sharp technique. Penultimate round of action for the one Super Series Flyweight World title. Jonathan Haggerty versus Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
I do like the counters of Haggerty so far. I like how he's throwing a combination. He steps, then he throws that right kick or that left kick, and he steps back. And that's when Rodtang starts to come forward, and Haggerty's able to hit him or something.
Front kick again from Haggerty, finding range. Outside leg kick from Rodtang.
All that pressure.
The hooking punches and the power up of the four-ounce box. You see Haggerty trying to slice and dice and fillet there with the uppercut elbow. Good front kick, nice long extension off the lead leg. Jab from Haggerty.
A little bit of deflection right there from Rodtang as that jab came in lightning fast.
Nice tip to the lead thigh from Haggerty. Then skips up inside thigh kick, threads the jab again, takes an outside lead kick. Body shots.
Oh, he's hurt.
The shots hurt him. The liver shots hurt the champion.
Haggerty's got to move.
And Rodtang knows it. He's going to go to that liver. He's going to try and blast the right side of the body of the champion. And Haggerty needs to find a way to cut him. Needs to find a way to open him up with the elbows now. And he drops it. The big kibosh. And Haggerty goes down. Referee O'Malley puts the count on. Haggerty's up on his feet. But he's been rattled. It was a beautiful hooking punch from Rodtang. And here comes the Iron Man. Here comes the tank. Ticking time bomb has exploded. Rodtang marching him down. Eats a jab. Haggerty circles away from the power side. There's a front kick. Haggerty's got to give himself a chance to recover. And Rodtang says, stop dancing. Come and engage with me. He's trying to get inside Haggerty's mind. He wants Haggerty to play his game. Wants him to suck it into a brawl. But Haggerty not falling for it. He's not going to take the bait yet. Oh, nice front kick there. A taste of the feet once again for Rodtang. Downward elbow. Hoping for the collarbone. Jab. But he's doing a Beyonce. He's going to the left, to the left. He's going to go to the right, to the right. Stay away from the power side of Rodtang.
He's doing a good job of slowing down. He says, this is for a belt. Come on, let's go toe to toe.
And how about this?
Get into it.
Haggerty calling Rodtang forward, saying, no, you come on, you bring it. I'm not coming to you, you've got to come to me.
Yeah, that's just mind games, though. He's still moving, though. He's on his bicycle. Looks at him, points to the ground, says, let's go.
Haggerty playing the mind games, saying, I made you lose your ground. Come on back into the phone booth.
Oh, it's going to come down to the fifth and final. That knockdown, Rodtang could have a slight edge in the scoring. If the scorecards, depends on how the judges saw that third round. It's very close right now. Look at him coming forward. Boom, with just a wild hooking combination, sends the champion crumbling to the mat as Rodtang starts to turn on the heat. Look at that right hand comes through the guard. And then Haggerty got on his bicycle and started circling, staying away from him. Keeping the taunting going, keeping it interesting. But you can tell Haggerty was hurt. This is a different Haggerty that we're seeing right now. Haggerty needs to reach down deep, develop that, bring out that champion's mindset, put it all on the line, because I think it comes down to the fifth and final round.
Such amazing respect I have for these two world champions. These two phenomenal athletes. And look at this sellout crowd in Manila at the Mall of Asia Arena, and what a show they've seen. This is one for the ages. Haggerty engaging in the mind games with Rodzak. And there's a moment of respect. The fifth and final round for the Flyweight Muay Thai world title. They touch gloves. It could be drawn at the moment. Once again, winning boxer gets 10 points. Losing boxer in the round, in your opinion, gets 9. Usually, if there's a knockdown, it's a 10-8 round.
Yeah, I think that knockdown changed it, though. I think it changed it. Beautiful evasion there from Rodtang.
Rodtang showboats. A little too slick. Roundhouse kick from the top. Haggerty, cheek down the center. Needs the elbows. 2 now. And not allow Rodtang to go to his liver and then sling the hand to the jaw. Those hooking punches of Rodtang are phenomenal. And the general goes to the legs. One way to slow down the punching of an opponent is to kick their legs. Every good punch begins from the bottom of the feet and comes up the body.
Haggerty's scoring with the leg kicks there, but you can see Rodtang catching the kick, sweeping out the leg, putting it down. Now dumps do count as a clean technique.
Tries to push kick. Haggerty. Rodtang may be waiting for the final 60 seconds or so here.
He can't wait, though. Haggerty's doing a lot of scoring here with his legs, pushing on the teeth.
Yeah, this
look at
is Haggerty's round so far. No
That's
doubt
scoring,
about it,
Michael. That's scoring. All these things are scoring.
Rodtang throws 2 punches, doesn't connect. Tucks the round kick on the forearm. Haggerty catches that one. There's one to the humerus, but there was nothing funny about it. Haggerty, nice roundhouse kick. Rodtang on the front foot, eats a jab. Body shots, then the hooks to the head. Chance for the knees and elbows on the inside here.
Strong into that clinch, wraps his hand around the head. There's a little bit of a knee, but chooses to let it go.
1:05 remaining, fifth and final round for the Flyweight Championship of the World. Jab 2 from Jonathan Haggerty. Front kick from Haggerty. It has been superb all night. It is the prime weapon of the champion. Nice stiff right hand. Rodtang apologizing. We're saying no, maybe Haggerty accidentally slipped a finger in the eye. It happens with these open gloves. Front kick, testing the waters here, Haggerty. And he thread an overhand elbow to the top of the head, perhaps. Or maybe skip in for a downward elbow to the collarbone.
30 seconds, Michael. This is it, right here. Last 30.
There's one of these two men pounce on the other now. Jab 2, a high kick from Jonathan Haggerty.
Nice 2 landing there by Haggerty as he cut through the guard.
This is going to be razor close, folks. This is going to be a razor close decision. Haggerty switches now back to orthodox.
Haggerty can take this round. It might be even, and they have to go to criteria for that.
No draws in one super series. No draws. We are going down to the judges. This is razor close. This is harder to pick than a broken nose. I don't know what to say about this one, Mitch.
If it's harder to pick than a broken nose. If it goes to the judges, if it, that's just scorecards. Your nose thing threw me off. And then right now it could be even. If Haggerty won that round, right now it could be even as a draw. Then it goes to the judges' scorecards. Then you have to factor in who did the most damage. And does the knockdown score the highest? It could go to, oh man, so many variables.
This is close. Wherever you're watching, folks, in over 140 countries around the world, how do you score it? Let us know on social media, let us know on Facebook, let us know on Twitter, at One Championship. Sellout crowd in Manila, loved every moment of it. Chandra Sitjatong there to present the championship bout to either Haggerty or Rodtang. So close, they are still tabulating here ringside. They want to get it right. It could go either way. It really could. Both men 22 years old, phenomenal athletes. It is the match we hope for and a lot more. Both men have their fists raised. Both believe they have won it. The sportsmanship, though, they let it all go in the ring and afterwards their mates. That's what true martial arts spirit is all about. That's that honor, integrity, respect, that Bushido code. This one is just razor thin. They are still counting the scorecards, double checking, triple checking, quadruple checking to make sure they get it right. It weight. And no matter who wins, I do not believe the other man would be disappointed because it is that close. Who's got it, folks? Do you have it for Rodtang, a veteran of 300 plus bouts, or do you have it for Haggerty, who's had only, I think, 16 professional bouts? Does Haggerty retain the crown? Does Rodtang take it? They are still tabulating here ringside. Now I see Dom Lau just double checking with officials to make sure on his card what he's about to read is correct. This may very well be the closest decision yet in one Super Series history. Okay, Dom Lau has the decision. Let's go now.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And new one Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
The emotional outpouring. The world champion. Rodtang Jitmuangnon, the Jet, the Iron Man.